Say, what's cracking, YouTube? It's your boy, 16 to Life, and I'm back like I'm on a parole violation. Y'all damn! Now, for those of y'all that's new to my page, in 1994, I got arrested. I was eventually sentenced to 16 years plus life. I ended up doing 24 years straight in the California prison system. During those times, I accumulated some good stories for y'all, and I'm going to hit y'all with one today. In the event you happen to enjoy this story, then definitely be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe to my channel. Also, hit the notification bell. That way, anytime I drop a story, you will be notified ASAP, and you can hop on that thing whenever you're ready. Definitely be sure to check my music out too, man. I got a song called Never Gave Me Therapy. Don't get it twisted. Like I tell y'all, some think that I'm a little older. I don't be rapping. I'm telling you, man, I gas. So definitely get at a checkout. It's Never Gave Me Therapy. It's on all major platforms. And you also can find the videos on my YouTube page. I got a couple of more songs that you can type in. Type in 16 to Life Music on YouTube. My songs will pop up. I got something called Never Tell, Ride With Me, By My Side, Tax Time, Surrender That Money, Revolution, a whole bunch of different songs, man. So check your boy out. Now, let's hop right into this story. I'm going to take y'all way back to 1995. At this time, I'm in the county jail and I'm still fighting my charges. I believe at that point in time, I already had 9 years plus life on one case, and I still had a trailing murder case, which I was fighting. Initially when I came into the county, like I told y'all, if you're familiar with my page, I'd got into a fight and I was cut in the back. So I was moved around, and eventually I end up making my way back to 3A, what was known as the Crip Tank. Now, so I don't know if you guys seen 60 Days In, but the tank that they had us in is somewhat similar to that. It's a big old giant tank with cells. And then when you come out of the cell, you in your day room, you know. Just so happened that 3A, it was the first take. And then it goes around kind of like in a circle. 3B is where they had the white dudes housed. And then 3C is where they had the Serenios housed. Now, in the middle, it's because when you come in, like it's a hallway, then right outside of that hallway, it's like a little bubble or a cubicle that the guard sits in, and he can see all these different pods and tanks and stuff, and he controls it from the control panel inside that little cubicle that he's in. So one day we sitting in there, we chilling, man. We in the day room and stuff. I definitely know we had on BET because that's what we always used to do. Listen to BET. We in there chilling, playing some dominoes or whatever, and a dude comes walking down the hallway, the rotunda. You know, he's got his orange jumpsuit on. He's another, you know, inmate or whatever. And he's going around. He's passing 3A and 3B and 3C. He's going around. Excuse me. He's going around to the visiting room to see his attorney. So now this story, I'm going to hit y'all with a couple of names, man. There happened to be a dude in there by the name of Popeye who was from Grape Street, and he was my neighbor. Now, when I say neighbor, I'm talking about he was my neighbor on the street. For years, he had lived two houses up the street from me. He happened to be in there fighting some serious charges. It was a dude named Dan Tanner from Long Beach Insane. It was a dude, Blue Eyes, from Fortre Gangsta Crip, you know, a dude by the name of Point Blank about a Riverside. It was a few cats up in there. And so Popeye happened to notice this dude walking. Now, I'm just calling for the intentions and purposes of this story. I'm going to call him TB. Now, Popeye had done time with TB in another institution somewhere, so he recognized him. So he hollered at him like, "Hey, TB, what's up, homie? What's cracking with you?" TB said, "Hey, what's up, man? I'm going on an attorney visit." So what it was, they had TB housed in another facility somewhere. He might have been out in Marietta, which is probably about 30 minutes away from Riverside, and they had brought him down to see his attorney. So he hollers at him, and he goes around the bend and goes toward the visiting room. So when he did that, the CO who was in the bubble, he happened to get on the loudspeaker. He said, "Hey, man, I don't know why you guys saying what's up to that dude. That dude is in PC. That dude is a snitch." And so the homie Popeye, he was like, "Oh, hell no, man. Oh, hell no, man. He got old boy fucked up. Because, okay, Popeye had done time, like I said previously, he had done time somewhere with TB. And at that particular prison, I can't remember if it was San Quentin or Soledad, somewhere, TB happened to be the Crip Mac Rep. Now, what a Mac Rep is basically a liaison between the prison administration and the convicts. Now, they no longer have Crip Mac Reps, but they just have Mac Reps. But back then, they had Crip Mac Reps, you know. So in the event there was an incident or something, you know, he would go speak to them and go back and let the prison administration just know the temperature of the, you know, the general consensus of the people that he was representing. Like, okay, they not tripping. Whatever issue we had is over. You can let us off lockdown or whatever, you know. So I say all that to say, for him to be the Crip Mac rep, he was definitely a well-respected individual. He's about a Compton, and he was definitely a well-respected individual. Around that time, he was about 39 years old. So anyway, like I say, he goes on to his visit. Now, we in the day room chilling. So after his attorney visit, he comes back again. So now when people are coming back from their visit or coming to put in the tank or whatever, there's a big old sliding glass door, you know. And so you can run to the side of the door. It's a crack in the door and talk. So Popeye ran to the side of the door. He was like, hey, TB, what's up, man? This motherfucker in the tower talking about you snitching. TB was like, oh, man, fuck that fool. I don't know that motherfucker. Fuck what he talking about. You know, they got me fucked up. So he continued walking because it's another guard escorting him. And they take him on out and, you know, probably down the hallway, back down the elevator to wherever he was at. Okay, so lo and behold, now, you know, we back to normal programming, doing what we doing. Lo and behold, I would say maybe about a couple of weeks later, maybe a month, here comes TB again. Now, he carrying a box in his hand. Now, this time, they open the door and he comes up in the tank now. So, you know, he goes to whatever cell he's assigned to, puts his little property away. Then he comes back to the day room and he's chilling. I can't quite remember who it was, but somebody get at him and address him like, hey, man, what's up with that, you know, what's up with that shit they talking about, man? The police was talking about you was snitching the last time you came through here. He like, oh, yeah, man, fuck that fool. I don't know what the fuck he talking about, man. So then he go to explaining a little bit of how he had caught a case out in Lake Elsinore with some young dudes, you know, and so that was that, you know. So like I say, by him being, you know, not only did Popeye know him, and I don't know if I mentioned, you know, he was a real respected dude, man. I don't know if I mentioned there was a few other dudes up in there by the name of, I know I said Dan Tanner from Insane. It was Blue Eyes. He was from Four Trade Gangsta Crip. You know, it was a few cats up in there, man. Blue Eyes definitely already knew TB from another institution or somewhere, you know. And so, you know, they in there chilling and chopping it up or whatever. Now, maybe come about 2 or 3 weeks later, they come putting another dude in the tank. Now, this dude, his name was T. Now, T supposedly was the dude who TB had told on. But at this point in time, T don't put him out there. And T also don't have the paperwork yet. I guess they had just got arrested recently. So later on, T was my cellie in Salinas Valley. So, okay. At that point in time, like I said, T don't have the paperwork to prove that this dude is snitching. But at some point in time, maybe a month or two down the line, they go to court together because they on the same case. And T is given the information by his attorney that TB is definitely telling on him in great detail. You know what I'm saying? And so now initially when T come back to the tank, T don't put TB out there, you know, because T is reading information. And so what he's trying to do, he's trying to go talk to TB now to get him to change his statement, you know, because now they together, they in the same pod. And, you know, T is looking at a gang of time. This is his third strike. You know, he's older, too. He's probably in his early 40s at that point in time. He looking at a gang of time, you know, so he's trying to now by him and him and TB being in the same tank. He trying to talk to him and, you know, trying to figure out a way they can beat this case or whatever. They had some type of robbery, possibly kidnap or some shit like that out there in Lake Elsinore. So like I say, they looking at a bunch of time. And at some point in time, T decided to let certain dudes in the tank know that TB was telling on him. Now, You had a couple of dudes up in there who was porters. I believe Dan Tanner was a porter, Popeye was a porter, and Blue Eyes was a porter. Now, what a porter is the person who was able to come out, you know, when everybody else is locked up and sweep up, clean up, you know, bullshit. You get to hang out an extra hour or two or whatever. So I wanted to be a porter. Now, just through by the strength of me knowing Popeye and me and him being neighbors, I had got in good with Dan Tanner. Now, I forgot to add that Dan Tanner was a big old giant dude, man. He was probably about 6 feet, 6'1", 255 pounds, all muscle. This dude was a big old dude, man. They had brought him to the county jail from prison when they still had the weights on another charge. So this dude was a big old giant dude, probably some 18, 19-inch arms on the hang, you know. And all the guards who worked up in there was pretty much scared of him. And before they would even put you in that crypt tank, they would ask you, man, are you cool with this dude? Because if not, y'all ain't cool, you know, he's up in there. So you may not want to go up in there. So they was real, you know, they was real fearful of this dude. So anyway, you know, I'm trying to get at him, Tanner, to have me be a porter. And he's telling me, oh, don't kick back, man. Kick back. He telling me, kick back. A spot going to come open pretty soon. And I'm talking about how, you know, because like I say, at this point in time, I'm 21, 22. So a lot of the stuff that's going on up in there is not even being known to me, you know. So, but they already knowing that they fist to, it's a move getting ready to be made. So what happens is this. Once they find out that TB is definitely telling on T, they press up on T. Now they like, okay, fuck what you talking about. You know, if you want to have this dude try to change his statement or some shit like that, that's on y'all. But you gonna have to either get on this dude's helmet or we gonna hop on your helmet, because this dude is telling you didn't put him out there. You know, the dude can't stay. So they end up pressing up on him. So he ends up, of course, having to press up on he has to press up on TB now. So they end up going down to a cell to catch a fade, you know. Now, I don't know why they picked this particular cell, because normally when dudes would go and fight, we had two cells at the end, number one, and I forget the one that was upstairs, but they was extremely big. They gave you a lot of room, but they went down to another cell. I think they might have went into Blue Eyes cell to fight. Now, I forgot to add, too, that TB was probably about 5'10". Probably about 140, 145 pounds, 150. He was extremely thin. T probably was probably about 6 feet, probably about, you know, 195, 200. He had much more weight on him. So definitely going into that small cell to fight was more to his advantage. So all of a sudden, you know, they go up in the cell, they close the door, they get the squabbing. Boom, beep, beep. You know, now when they, like I say, the cells is all concrete. So when they up in there squabbing, all you hear is basically just like a lot of rumbling, you know. They up in there rumbling, you know. Then all of a sudden, it just goes real quiet. Then suddenly, T come up out of there. He opened the door and walk up out of there. He like, yeah, nigga, that's what it is. Get that snitch ass nigga up out of there. So now, Blue Eyes, since I believe it was his cell, and he told me this later, he goes up in there to get TB. Now, TB is totally unconscious. He's all the way out. So Blue Eyes said he grabbed one of his rags and wet it, and now he's trying to wake up TB. He actually told me, he said, chill, man, I was so disappointed in that bitch-ass motherfucker. I was slapping his bitch-ass extra hard. So he's slapping him in the face to wake him up. Now, I bullshit you not, this is what Blue Eyes told me. He said when the boy TB woke up, he said, Blue Eyes, how'd I do? Blue Eyes said, man, you got your bitch-ass beat. Now get your snitch-ass up out of here. So they got him up, took him out the cell, and he was gone. You know what I'm saying? So now, long story short, TB definitely was telling, because he came to court and ended up telling on T, and T ended up getting something like 145 years to life, you know. And a lot of dudes couldn't believe that, man, because TB, who happened to be like around 39 years old, because I heard him initially when he first came in the tank, he was saying, man, I don't know who the fuck them youngsters is. He said, man, I'm 39 years old. What the fuck I'm doing hanging with some 18, 19 year olds? So he tried to make it seem like the dudes in his case were some youngsters, but come to find out, no, him and the dude T, they was around the same age. So, but that's how I remember knowing what age he was, you know. So anyway, a lot of the dudes up in there, man, was extremely disappointed in TB, because like I said, he was a MAC rep. You know, he was a spokesman for all Crips. So that said a whole lot about him. You know, the dude was a Crip with a well-known reputation. But that also goes to show that just because a dude is solid in 1989 don't mean he can't be unsolid in 1992. Things happen, man. So everybody talking that they with the business and they with the shit is not always with the shit. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, they end up giving my boy T a gang of time. Like I said, man, big, big time. Now, let me tell y'all, too, about some other individuals that I named off, man, who got a gang of time, because I be thinking about this shit and reminiscing. Okay, my boy Popeye, who had been my neighbors for years, Popeye ended up getting the death penalty. It was another dude in there by the name of Point Blank. Point Blank was from Riverside. Now, Point Blank was about 19 or 20 years old. He ended up also getting the death penalty. There was another dude who wasn't in there at this particular time, but he happened to be in there earlier by the name of Wiz. Wiz was a young dude. He ended up getting the death penalty as well. It was another dude that I was in there with, who I had grew up with. His name was Tankin. Tankin was a couple of years younger than me. I've been knowing Tankin and his family all my life. Tankin was like about 19 years old. Tankin ended up getting life without parole. I don't know if you guys are familiar with some of my other stories I was telling you about Stutterbox. I thought Stutterbox had got 25 years to life. Came to find out, no. Stutterbox ended up getting life without parole. So imagine, man, being 19, 20 years old, and they tell you, you got life without parole. Your life is over. You know what I'm saying? Caught up in the streets, man, your life is over. You know, there was a lot of individuals that I was in there with that end up getting a gang of time. Like me, myself, I got 16 years plus life. So, you know, I'm just letting y'all know, man, the streets is real. And for everybody that thinks that just because a dude tell you that he's solid or even he didn't been to jail a time or two, don't mean that he won't get caught up on a case where he may not feel like going back to jail this time. He's facing too much time. And now suddenly he feeling that telling is his best option. So, man, y'all just be aware. And now that I'm thinking about it, too, you know, because I never thought about it before. The police definitely set old boy up. Definitely set old TB up, because like I say, when he came through there the first time, the police said, hey, man, that dude is a snitch. And then so later on, now, if you guys know he's a snitch, it must be something on his bed card or something that lets you know that he's in special housing. So later on, they end up putting him in 3A, which was the Crip tank. Then suddenly later on, a couple of weeks later, the dude that he was telling on came up in there. So, you know, I just said all that to say, don't think that the guards is going to save you, because the guards be up in there and they have people that they like and dislike for whatever reasons, too. I don't know. And sometimes, you know, people get into it with the guards. They cuss the guards out. They'll use their power and their control, and they're being in control of moving people to certain, you know, certain places. They'll manipulate that and try to put you in a position that's precarious and dangerous and can definitely get you fucked up and hurt, you know. So, like I say, I never really gave that much thought before, but now I thought about it, you know, and they definitely played a part in trying to get that dude set up and hurt, you know. So, yeah, man, I hope y'all enjoyed that story right there, man. It's your boy 16 of Life. Y'all already know what it is. Resume normal program.